Hello everyone, in this video you have one square, one semicircle, one triangle, and the area of this triangle is asked. Okay. First up, if here is tangent, you know that this line was drawn from the center of semicircle. So here must be center. These are 5 units because of square, and this length is also 5 units. And then if we draw a perpendicular line opposite of the 10 units, let's call here alpha and here theta. Alpha plus theta equals 90 degrees, right? That means this angle must be alpha. And if we draw a perpendicular line again, this angle must be theta. If you notice that, we get two similar triangles. This triangle and this triangle are similar because they have same angles. Let's call here K point. OKD triangle and let's call here M point, DMC triangle are similar. Ratio of the length which are opposite of the 90 degrees are 2. That means if opposite of the theta equals x, opposite of the theta must be equal to x. Therefore, if it is 2x, this length must be 10 minus 2x. Why? Because we know that according to two tangent theorem, length of the DC must be equal length of the TC, right? Therefore, if it is 10 units, this length is 10 and this length is also 10 units. So if it is 2x, this length must be equal 10 minus 2x. So this length is also 10 minus 2x because of rectangle. Therefore, if we apply triangle similarity, x over 2x equals opposite of the alpha is 10 minus 2x over opposite of the alpha equals, if it is 5, this length is also 5. So opposite of the alpha equals x plus 5. Therefore, x plus 5 equals 20 minus 4x. So 5x equals 15, x is going to be 3 units. Okay, therefore we know that this triangle area is asked. So if we draw a perpendicular line here, if it is alpha, this angle must be theta and this angle must be alpha. Therefore, if you notice that, we get two congruent triangles. DMC triangle and let's call this point L, CLT triangle are congruent because they have same angles and across 90 degrees are the same length. That means this two triangle must be congruent. So if there's a 2x opposite of the theta, opposite of the theta must be 2x. Okay. Now we have a height and base, so we can calculate the area very easily. The area equals half of the base and height. So the area equals 10x, x equals 3, therefore the area equals 30 unit square. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of the area using second method. You know that these are radius, and if it is 10, this 3 length equal 10, and if you notice that this is a kite, right? So if we connect this two corner, these two angle must be equal because of kite, and this angle must be 90 minus 2 alpha. And then let's calculate this triangle area using sine formula. 1 over 2 times 10 times 10 times sine 90 minus 2 alpha, right? So 50 times, we can calculate cosine 2 alpha instead of sine 90 minus 2 alpha, and we know that cosine 2 alpha equals 1 minus tangent squared alpha over 1 plus tangent squared alpha. That means if you calculate tangent alpha, we get the cosine 2 alpha. So we know that here is 5 units, and tangent alpha equals 5 over 10, that means 1 over 2. So cosine 2 alpha equals 1 minus 1 over 2 whole squared over 1 plus 1 over 2 whole squared. Therefore, 1 minus 1 over 4 over 1 plus 1 over 4. Therefore, cosine 2 alpha equals, it is minus 3 over 4 over 5 over 4. So cosine 2 alpha is going to be 3 over 5. Therefore, the area equals 50 times 3 over 5. So the area is going to be 30 unit square. Thanks for watching. Bye.